Hi, I'm James Montemagno, Program Manager for Mobile Developer Tools here at Microsoft. And today, I want to show you how you can start leveraging serverless architecture in your mobile applications with Azure Functions. Azure Functions enable you to build out serverless compute event-driven architecture. This means that they can scale on demand and you pay for only what you use. So let's head over to Visual Studio and get started. Here we are inside of Visual Studio 2017. Now I've created my Xamarin application and I'll walk through it in a few seconds, but the first thing that we're gonna do is create our Azure function as our web API backend. I'm gonna go into Visual Studio and say add new project. Now under cloud, we'll see Azure Functions. Here we'll give it a name. I'll just say function app 1 and hit okay. This will bring up our dialog for creating a new Azure function. There's several different events that I can trigger into, such as an empty, HTTP trigger, or timer trigger. I'm just gonna go ahead and select the HTTP trigger that will call from our mobile application and select OK. This will create all the scaffolding that I need for my Azure function. Now let's take a look at what it created as it's restoring our NuGet packages. Here we'll have function 1 and a function name of function 1. Whenever this is called, it's going to take an HTTP trigger with a GET and POST, and it'll automatically route it. Now, what the default Azure function does is take in any parameters and specifically looks for name. It will then return hello name from the Azure function. So this means that we can immediately start using this Azure function from our mobile application, but we can also debug it locally first. So I'll set it as the startup project and hit debug. This will compile the Azure function on my local machine and launch into a debug session. So here the Azure function CLI or command line interface will come up and it will give me a URL that I can call into. So let's just go ahead and copy that really quick. And then I'll come into the browser and I'll go ahead and paste it. Now it's running on my local machine and we haven't passed it any arguments. So it says, please pass a name parameter. So I'll say name equals James. And now it will go ahead and execute that Azure function. So now I have it in a perfect state. And then it's time to actually deploy it to Azure. So now that the Azure function's ready, we'll right click on function app 1 and then say publish. Here, if I already have an existing Azure app surface, I can go ahead and select it, but I'm gonna go ahead and create a new one and select publish. This will load up all of my subscriptions since I'm logged into my Microsoft account. It will tell me that I need to create a new app name, select a subscription, a resource group that I would like to put it in. Let's go ahead and create a new resource group and I'll say my function apps. Then it'll go ahead and ask me about where I would like to host it. So we'll go ahead and create a new hosting plan and a new storage account. On the right-hand side, I can optionally create a new SQL database, storage account, and then it will tell me exactly what it will be creating. And when I select create, it will go off to Azure to spin up the Azure function and deploy my code. So let's give it a few seconds to deploy this. Now our Azure function has been deployed. Now, if I update the code, I can always republish into Azure. So let's hop over into the portal and take a look at what was deployed. Here I am inside my resource group, so we'll go ahead and hit refresh. And here's my function apps. Inside of this resource group will house everything that I created, including my storage account, my Azure function, and my plan. And when I tap on that function, it will bring me into the Azure function dashboard for everything that I've just deployed. You can have multiple functions as part of a function app. So here's that function 1 that I created. Here's the function.json, which is telling me that it's using an HTTP trigger and that it's function app 1 DLL. Here, we can get a function URL, and this is what we'll use inside our mobile application. Now, this is just going to be open-ended with a code as authentication. You can always add user authentication on to an Azure function later on. I'm going to go ahead and copy this. I'll go ahead and bring it back into the tab, and I'll go ahead and paste that URL in there. And we'll see the full URL, and I'm going to hit an ampersand name equals Azure. And now it'll say, hello, Azure. So we're calling our Azure function that is running in the cloud. I can take this URL and bring it back into my mobile app and start calling it from my Xamarin application. So back in Visual Studio, let's take a look at the Xamarin application. I've created one for both iOS and Android. We're using a shared XAML user interface. So what I've done is created a little bit of user interface to enter a name, a label to display the results, and a button to click so I can query the API backend. Now here I've just done it in the code behind. I could optionally put in MVVM and data binding in here too. Here we'll go ahead and see that there's a button clicked event. It's going to call HTTP client and get a string asynchronously back, and then return that result and display it to the user. Else it will catch any exceptions and put error. So I'm going to go ahead and just paste that URL in there. Now it's a very, very long URL, so we'll go ahead and split this up here and add it down on a new line. Now what we can do is actually change it so it's not just Azure at the end. It can be configurable to whatever we type. So I'm going to say ampersand name equals, and we'll want to go ahead and use some C# string interpolation. So I'll put dollar signs in front of the string. We'll see IntelliSense light up here, and I'll say entry name.text. There we go. So now whenever I click that button, it'll call my Azure function, get the string result, and display it to our user. I'll go ahead and set Android as my startup project, and we can go ahead and hit debug. What I'll be able to do is add breakpoints and then call it immediately from the mobile application. Here our application is deployed, and here it is. By default, it says welcome to Xamarin Forms, but I'll say James. I'll say query API. This will go into the backend, and we'll have our result. As I scroll down, we'll see hello James, and we'll go ahead and display that back in the user interface. There we have it. In just a few moments, we're able to easily integrate our Azure function as our backend for our mobile application. And there you go. We've just built and deployed our very first Azure function from Visual Studio and deployed it into Azure and called it from our mobile application built with Xamarin. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out, and thanks for watching.